Around 7 million people in the UK are covered by health insurance, the majority being covered through their employers. The problem is that few have really studied their policy documents and many misunderstand what is covered. And perhaps just as important, what isn't. If you expect health insurance to pay all your health costs, you're mistaken. Health insurance is designed to provide protection for curable, short-term health problems and allow policyholders to jump the NHS queues to see consultants, be diagnosed, receive surgery or be treated. That sounds fine, but before you buy you need to appreciate the treatments and situations that fall outside the scope of the cover. But first a word of warning. This article does not relate to any specific policy and the terms and conditions issued by individual insurers do vary. So please ensure you also check your policy documents. After reading this article, you'll know what to look out for. Sorry, it's a chronic condition. If a condition can be cured and is not a long-term problem, your insurance company will classify it as acute and should meet the cost. If your problem is incurable or it's a problem that, despite appropriate treatment, will be with you for a long time, then your insurance company will classify it as chronic, and no, you won't be covered. But drawing a firm line between what is acute and what is chronic is fraught with problems, and leads to the biggest area of conflict between insurer and policyholder. Everyone agrees that diabetes and asthma are chronic conditions as you're likely to suffer from them for the rest of your life. So those sorts of conditions are not covered. Problems arise when the medical team initially considers a patient's illness to be curable, but the condition subsequently deteriorates and the doctors change their mind, it's now become incurable. This can happen especially in the treatment of some types of cancer. In these circumstances, the condition is initially defined as acute and is therefore insured, but deteriorates and becomes chronic, and outside the terms of cover. This is possible as insurers retain the right to reclassify a condition from acute to chronic during treatment. Sorry, it's too long-term, the insurance company will not pay out for long-term treatment. But you need to check your policy documents to see how they define long-term. You can find the situation where a course of drugs extends for say 12 months, but the insurer will only pay for 10 months. Sorry, it's preventative, your insurance is designed to pay for the treatment and cure of conditions when they arise. It is not designed to pay for treatments that are used to prevent an illness. Again, the problem of definition arises. Sometimes it is arguable whether a treatment is preventative or a cure. Take the drug Herceptin for example. This drug can be used in the early stages of breast cancer. Research shows that Herceptin can have the incidence of cancer returning for women who have a particularly virulent form of the cancer known as HER2. Insurance companies are split on the debate. Norwich Union, WPA, Bupa and Standard Life Healthcare will pay for Herceptin for HER2 patients whereas Legal & General and AXAPPP will not. Sorry, the drug is not approved. Two of the main attractions for taking out health insurance are to jump the queues at the NHS, and to get the latest treatments and drugs. But there's a rider. Click the link in the description to get the best product in the market, proven to work.